Welcome back to Big Movie Mouth Off. We're here reviewing more movies at Broovy Cinema Pub. I'm Jeff Feist with MSN Entertainment.
I'm Jimmy Martin with Slug Magazine. You can find the Big Movie Mouth Off. Maybe you've already found it, but if you haven't, it's Xfinity, Channel 6. Also on their on-demand system, Utah On Demand, Salt Lake Alternative. Just tons of stuff. Mm-hmm. I'm not even going to ruin it for you. There'll be no spoiler alerts.
Yes,
just go find it.
And we'll be doing the same thing with the movie we're reviewing this week, Looper. Ooh. The third feature from Rian Johnson, the guy who wrote and directed Brick, as well as The Brothers Bloom. He could not have made a more different third film.
And that's good.
This is a trippy science fiction thriller with noirish tendencies. Joseph Gordon-Levitt stars. By the way, you might remember he teamed with Rian Johnson for Brick. Stars as Joe. He's a looper, as it turns out.
What's a looper?
He's a hitman. And as it turns out, by the way, this is set in the near future. As it turns out, even farther in the future than that, gangsters have discovered time travel, and they're using it as a way to dispose of people. They send people 30 years back into the past, looper shoot them, and get rid of the body, so there's no trace.
And that's all they do, really. I mean, like, they pop up in the time, and pow, and that's it.
And the last plot detail I will reveal is this. Looper's careers end when their loop is closed, which is when their older version is sent to them to dispose of.
And closing the contract.
Absolutely.
And they're paid handsomely for their work. And basically and they kind of agree to this. It's not like it's a surprise to them.
No.
And then once they find out that they have 30 killed minutes, themselves.
Yeah, then they have 30 minutes or 30 years.
30 years. Enjoy your 30 years and that's it. You know, and that's their job, that's their lives, you know.
Lo and behold, older Joe, played by Bruce Willis, pops up and escapes.
And wackiness ensues.
And thus progresses the trippiest science fiction thriller we've seen since 12 Monkeys. And by the way, the best way I can describe this plot is imagine if the Terminator and 12 Monkeys had a baby.
In the future, time travel is outlawed. Used only in secret by the largest criminal organizations. When they need someone gone and they want to erase any trace of the target ever existing, they use specialized assassins like me, called loopers.
You're a looper.
You know what we do? And the only rule is never let your target escape, even if your target is you. Not a good thing. My boss will be searching for me until he finds me.
Sweep the streets. Get on it.
I'm gonna fix this! I'm gonna find him! I'm gonna kill him!
Hunt them down. But every second that passes is bad.
What's he gonna do?
I'm gonna save your life.
My life! Your life!
I know you're not lying when you say you're gonna kill this guy.
For me, this is an absolute dream project because I have always joked. If you know anything about me, my two favorite genres in this world are hitman movies and time traveling movies. And I always made a joke that I would make a time traveling hitman movie. Well, lo and behold, he did it.
Yep.
And my God, it is amazing. I mean, this film, it just is purely original. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Like, in a world where everything we kind of get nowadays is just, you know, the sequel or the remake.
And predictable.
Yeah.
And predictable. Know? And there was never a time in Looper that I felt I knew what was going to happen later.
No.
Also, a favorite game I like to play with thrillers is to check plot holes.
Yeah.
I noticed what could have been plot holes in Looper, wrote them down in my notebook, and then later, when Rian Johnson was smart enough to close that loop, cross them out. Guess how many plot holes I had left when the film was done? I had zero.
No, I mean, this film
Kudos,
is so
Rian Johnson.
Well thought out. The tricks they play with time travel are, I mean, I'm not even spoiling that, because you know what scene I'm talking about. And every critic in this theater was on the ground, you know, jaws on the ground, clapping about how imaginative this world is. It's just even the visual style. There are shots in this film. I said this about Drive last year, where there are shots in these films that can be done very simple, very easy. You know, you know, it's like someone walking down a hallway.
Right.
Something so dumb. But you know what? They take the time to make it artistic and make it almost a portrait. And there's a part where, you know, he falls off a building and like the camera rotates, you know, with him. And it's just, obviously they're like, my God, I mean, falling off a building and getting the shot itself is good enough for me, you know?
Absolutely. And then you get an alternate perspective on that scene later. God.
Yeah, they kind of do like, I would say like the Back to the Future where Marty's seeing himself, you know, doing different aspects. And they do this. And it's so fun.
Now, I have to admit, at first, I had some hesitancy about Joseph Gordon-Levitt digitally and makeup-wise altered to look and sound like older Bruce Willis.
It just works.
Those concerns went right away very fast.
I think, you know, and I've said it before with 50-50, I think Joseph Gordon-Levitt is one of the greatest actors working today. And just to see him emulating every mannerism and speech pattern of Bruce Willis.
But it's not a character. It's not a caricature.
It's almost just natural.
Absolutely. And you actually start to notice it less and less as the film goes.
You know, 5 minutes into it, I was done. You know, because he looks slightly off. You're like, God, is that Joseph Gordon-Levitt? And you're like, all right, yeah, I believe it.
So I'm staring into your eyes. It's too strange.
Your face looks backwards. So do you know what's gonna happen? You done all this already, as me?
I don't wanna talk about time travel. Because if we start talking about it, then we're gonna be here all day talking about it, making diagrams with straws.
We both know how this has to go down. I can't let you walk away from this diner alive. This is my life now. I earned it. You had yours already. So why don't you do what old men do and die?
Why don't you just take your little gun out from between your legs and do it? Boy.
I mean, the action's great, the thrill, I mean,
Willis is great, Emily Blunt, who has a small but crucial role.
Yeah.
Very great. Jeff Daniels, as the head of the mob, in one of those tiny, tiny roles.
But just is perfect for it.
Yes.
It's one of those films, seriously, I think it's in the top five, if not higher, of greatest time traveling movies of all time.
Well, I'll just say this. This so far blows away everything else science fiction-wise that's come out in years.
Yeah.
In years.
It's that smart. It's that original.
Yeah. It's one of those that will be talked about not just in the weeks to come, but years to come.
We were talking about this. I hope this becomes a hit. Just to prove that everybody that was involved in this deserves every accreditation they can get.
Absolutely, and we're talking about it, about its cerebral tendencies, but there are genuine thrills, exciting moments in this too. This is a film that you can appreciate not just only if you're a thinky science fiction fan, if you're a noir thriller fan, just if you like action movies, because there's some very, very exciting action in this film.
And again, with that side of just visually stunning.
Absolutely.
You know, that just adds that much more to it.
Four stars.
Yeah, there's no way I wasn't going to give it four stars. I mean...
And I sort of feel sorry for the rest of the films this year now that I'm sure there will be great films, great, great films to come. But this is so original that it sort of casts a pall over everything else that is to come.
And it's, like I say, bizarre and just odd that it is. Like, you're kind of like, man, maybe this could happen.
Yeah, and enthralling. And by the way, there's a necessary and well-thought-out emotional component to this film, too.
Yeah.
Like, more so than the rest of Rian Johnson's films.
So to conclude, for the love of God, go see Looper.
Please.
Support it, see it, see it again.
Absolutely.
See it for three times.
Yes. And by the way, please to support our sponsors for this episode.
Absolutely. Sponsor of this episode is Castle of Chaos. It's the haunted houses. I mean,
speaking of thrills.
Yeah, if you want a thrill, go see Castle of Chaos. They have three locations all around the Utah Valley.
Redwood Road, Orem, and Ogden.
That's right. It's. I'd say it's probably one of the. Well, it's funny. I would say one of the best because there's three of them. So they kind of, to me and me, they compete with each other,
right.
But they're all really good. So support our sponsors. Go check out Castle of Chaos in this Halloween season, and be sure to check out Looper when you're done at the haunted house. Absolutely. Two thrills, how about that?
Yeah.
That's a deal.
See what you have looking forward.
All right, well, we will see you next time. See you, Looper.